try to be in touch with, you know, with a system that you really want to study, with a system that really drives you crazy, because that's how you nurture passion. And passion is one of the most important things on becoming a researcher. My name is Moises. I am a fish biologist, also known as an ichthyologist. I'm a Ph.D. student for the University of Texas at Austin, although I'm conducting my research from the California Academy of Sciences here in San Francisco. How I got into this field is actually a very interesting story. I'm originally from Panama. I actually moved here to the U.S. to do my Ph.D., and all my experience before that was in Panama, which is a tropical country. And when I was a kid, I would do a lot of snorkeling, and I would always be very, very intrigued by all the colors of the fishes and also all the creatures that were in that complex environment that is coral reef systems. One of the things that I did when I was in high school that changed my perspective of life in general was getting scuba certified. It really, really cemented my interest in marine biology, and it really cemented my interest in actually becoming a biologist. At the age of 16, I started diving quite a bit. And when I started diving, I got really, really obsessed with marine biology. When you talk about ichthyology, you can do multiple things. In this case, it encompasses a broad spectrum of study. So there's a lot of people that are related with systematics and try to determine how each fish relates with each other. The kind of study that I do on fishes is that I try to study their genome to try to understand their evolutionary history in order to try to understand why and how there's such high fish diversity in certain portions of the world. One of the biggest challenges for me in becoming a researcher is that my first language is Spanish. It was really, really challenging at first, you know, trying to write in English the whole time, try to communicate in English the whole time, trying to receive classes in English the whole time. And it took me probably about a year until I was really comfortable, and it was not an exhaustive process. Like I would be literally exhausted by the end of the day. There's many tasks that you have to do at a given time. A lot of people don't think that they have to write really well, but when you're a scientist, you're gonna spend a lot of time writing. So pay attention to your writing classes, your literature classes. You are also gonna have to do, you know, the genetic analysis. You're gonna have to analyze the data in the lab with the computers. You're gonna have to do a lot of statistical analysis to try to infer what's going on with that genetic data. And you're gonna have to write those results in a really good fashion for your peers to understand it. Another part that's really, really exciting about being a fish biologist is that you get to go to the field to collect your samples, and that's probably the preferred part of a lot of biologists. The thing that I probably love the most about this is that when you go to the field and you observe something, you can start asking all these questions about that particular observation, and then you have to come up with ways to try to answer that particular question. And in the end, that answer might become part of like the general human knowledge. Even if it's like a really tiny smidge of knowledge, it actually is incrementing the knowledge that you're giving to mankind. And that's a satisfaction and a gratification that you feel that no one can take out of you.